show you how I'm nothing like him. Swear that's the truth. You can't trust that I'll always stand the rain. Tell me what you need to see. I ain't running away, 'cause I'm right here with you like I need to be. I'm right here, I ain't ever gonna leave. I know you hurt, but I'm not the same song. Different star with me, that's where you belong, girl.
I'm going to show you how to make a lyric video using PowerDirector. It's time to sing. As you can see, I have some music on track one. I have the lyrics of a song in a text document. Now I have it there so I can copy and paste things into the editor. First thing that you want to do is add titles to the timeline. So you want to go to the title room. You want to use a default title. You want to left click that with your left mouse button, hold down your left mouse and drag it down to track two. You want to double left click on the title. And you want to change your background. I'm going to use a background that's white. You can use whatever background you want. I'm going to click on white and I'm going to click on open. Now I'll click on stretch so that it fills everything out. Next, we'll click on OK. And you can trim out the title to however long you need it to be. You can trim it out to the end of the song, a different time, whatever. I'm going to hold my cursor at the end of this until I see two arrows pointed in opposite directions. Hold down my left mouse, and I'm going to drag it out. Now, for this lyric video, I'm going to add an additional title. So I'm going to go to default again, hold down my left mouse button, and I'm going to drag it down to where I want the title to start. And then we'll place our cursor at the end until we see two arrows pointed in opposite directions, and we'll drag this out to where we want the title to stop. Next, you need to listen to the song and split the titles where each phrase begins. I'm going to place my cursor where I know one of the phrases starts. And then I'm going to click on the title and I'm going to do Control T on my keyboard and it will split that clip. So I'm just going to keep doing that until I have all the splits that I need in both of these titles. I'm going to fast forward through that so you don't have to live through the pain. Now that we got all of those splits done, we need to edit the text. So you want to double left click on your first title. And you want to copy the text from your text editor and paste it into the title section. You want to double click in the text box to highlight it. And you want to go ahead and change your color. You want to change your font, make it whatever you want. You want to change your font size. And then you want to adjust your font and get it centered. And when you're done, go ahead and click on OK. So you don't want to have to do that for each and every one of these, all those adjustments. So what you could do is just copy the attributes and paste it to the clips that you need. So I'm going to right click on this first clip that we made some adjustments to. And I'm going to go to copy title attributes. And then I'm going to left click on the clips that I need to go ahead and change the title on. I'm going to right click. And I'm going to do paste title attributes. When you get that pop up, just click on OK. So now that we got everything pasted in and all of the titles have the same text, the same color, same font, I'm going to go ahead and add an animation to the first title. So I'm going to double click on it. I'm going to go to animation. I'm going to choose the in animation. And for this one, I'm going to choose zoom. I'm going to choose the out animation. And I'm going to use the same animation out. And I don't want it to start right at the beginning. So I'm going to left click on the animation here. Place my cursor at the beginning until I see a line with two arrows. I'm going to hold on my left mouse. I'm going to drag it to the position that I want it to start at. And now I'm going to click on OK. So now I'm going to go ahead and do the animation and change the text for all of the titles. I'm going to fast forward through that because I already showed you how to change the text and how to change the animations. Now that all of our text is set up, we can go ahead and place any images where we want to place them. So first I'm going to use some of the overlays that come with PowerDirector. So I'm going to go to the PIP room or the overlay room. I'm going to go down to Neon Stickers Pack. And I'm going to use this fire here. I'm going to left click, hold on my left mouse, and drag it down under this first title on track 3. And I'm going to place my cursor at the end until I see those two arrows. Hold down my left mouse and drag it to the end of this clip here. I'm also going to use these glasses. So I'm going to left click, hold down my left mouse button, and drag these down under this title here. To drag it to wherever you want it. Once again, I'm going to hold my cursor over the end, hold down my left mouse when I see these two arrows, and I'm going to drag it in. That's the same length as this title. Next, I'm going to go to the media room. And I'm going to use some of the images that I went ahead and imported into the program. These I got from Digital Juice. I'll leave a link in the video description if you're interested in signing up with them and using some of their assets. First, I'm going to use this rain. I'm going to go ahead and hold down my left mouse over it, drag it down to a position where I want it to start. I'm going to go ahead and hold my cursor over the end, and I'm going to trim this in to the end of this clip here. I'm going to right click on it because I want to make the black background disappear. I just want to see the rain falling. And I'm going to go ahead and go to edit video. I'm going to go to set blending mode. And I'm going to choose difference. And I'm going to go ahead and double left click on it to open it up. And I'm going to drag the scale over to just make it fill out the whole screen. And then I'll go ahead and click on OK. Then I want to use this image of a guy running. I'm going to hold down my left mouse over it and drag it down to where I want to place it on the timeline. And I'm going to place my cursor over the end until I see these two arrows. Hold down my left mouse and I'm going to drag it in. Now I'm going to double left click on this to open up the PIP designer. And I'm going to move my playhead to the beginning. I'm going to place a position keyframe here at the beginning. I'm going to change the position so that he's all the way over off on the right-hand side of the screen. You can just drag him over if you want. I'm just going to type in the parameter that I want. And then I'm going to move my playhead to the end. And now I'm going to type in the parameters, the X parameter that I want. You can drag him over to the other side of the screen. I'm just going to type it in. And hit enter. Now I'm going to go to motion. And I'm going to enable motion blur. And if I go back to properties and I scrub the timeline, you'll see that he goes across the screen. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK.
And the next picture I want on here is this one here. So it's called Hurt. I'm going to hold down my left mouse button over it. I'm going to drag it down to the position where I want it to be on the timeline. And then I'm going to go ahead and trim the end so that it matches the length of this title here. Next, we want to add some assets to track one and some transitions to go ahead and clean everything up. So I'm going to start off by using a color board. So I'm going to go up to color boards. And I'm going to drag this color board down to the time that I want it to start. Place my cursor at the end, and I'm going to go ahead and drag it in and trim it. I'm going to go back to the media content. I'm going to use this background here. So I'll left click, hold down my left mouse button and drag it down. And since it's a looping track, I'm just going to drag it down again. And the loop will just be seamless. I'll drag it down one more time. Then I'm going to trim this to a position that I want this to end at. And then I'm going to drag this heart image down after it. So I'll just go ahead and hold down my left mouse button and drag it down. And I'll trim it so it matches the end of the clip. Now I'm going to add the transitions in to clean things up. So I'm going to go to the transition room. I'm going to go to general. I'm going to add a fade transition. I'm going to hold up my left mouse and drag this between these two clips. And I'm going to drag another fade transition to the end of this clip. It's too long, so I'm going to click on duration. And I'll change it to 12 frames and hit enter. And I'm going to drag a fade transition to the rain. I'll go ahead and click on the duration again. And change that to 12 frames. And hit enter. And I'm going to add one to the end as well. Do the same thing. And I'm going to use a custom transition that I made. You can make your own transitions with this program, which is really cool. I made one called Heartbeat, so I'm going to drag it here between the heart and the background layer there. And now we want to add an effect to the heart, so I'm going to left click on it. I'm going to go to effects, drag the beating effect onto the heart. And now we can play this back and enjoy the fruits of our labor.
Show you how I'm nothing like him. Swear that's the truth. You can't trust that I'll always stand the rain. Tell me what you need to see. I ain't running away. 'Cause I'm right here with you like I need to be. I'm right here. I ain't ever gonna leave.
Now, you're a lyrical assassin. If you want to make a karaoke video, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.